Can you believe that we generate over 400 million terabytes of data every single day? That's the equivalent of every person on Earth taking 40,000 photos a day each, or enough to fill 1.3 billion smartphones worth of storage. Every single minute, we post 350,000 tweets, send 16 million text messages, and conduct 6 million Google searches. That's a mind-blowing amount of data. But without data analytics, it doesn't mean much at all. Data analytics takes all that raw data and turns it into something meaningful that organizations can use to make better decisions. It's an incredibly important field, and we're going to explain exactly what it is. We'll also explore what a data analyst does and outline the top skills needed for the role. So, are you ready? Let's jump in. Data analytics is the process of collecting raw data and analyzing it to uncover patterns, trends, and insights. These insights are used to guide decision making, whether it's figuring out what products are most likely to sell, identifying financial risks, even maybe helping a sports team refine their game strategies based on player performance data. Have you ever wondered how Spotify seems to know what music you want to hear next? Or how YouTube always has that perfect video lined up for your next watch? That's the power of data analytics. Brands like Spotify and YouTube continuously collect and analyze data to understand your preferences and habits. They then use these insights to make on-point recommendations. And data analytics isn't just about boosting entertainment value or driving sales. It's also crucial in all kinds of sectors, from government to education to urban planning, even healthcare. In a hospital setting, for example, data analytics is used to track patient outcomes, predict potential health risks, and develop personalized treatment plans. No matter the industry or context, data analytics converts information into actionable intelligence. That's what makes it so powerful. Data-driven companies are 5 times more likely to make faster decisions. They're also 23 times more likely to win new customers, and they tend to achieve higher revenue than their non-data-driven competitors. That's because data empowers organizations to understand their customers on a deeper level and deliver more engaging products and services. It also helps to improve internal processes, boost operational efficiency, and make sure that resources are allocated where they can make the most impact. So, now that we know what data analytics is and why it's such a big deal, let's consider the 4 main types of data analytics. Data analytics is all about answering questions. What happened? Why did it happen? What's likely to happen next? And what should we do about it? To answer these questions, you need 4 main types of data analytics: descriptive, diagnostic, predictive, and prescriptive. Descriptive analytics tells you what happened in the past. An e-commerce company might analyze last quarter's sales data to see which products sold the most, for example. Diagnostic analytics asks, why did this happen? It digs deeper to identify the reasons behind a particular trend or issue. Why were the products so popular? Why did sales drop last quarter? Did customer preferences change? Or is there just a flaw in the checkout process? Then you've got predictive analytics, which looks at what could happen next. This uses historical data to forecast future outcomes, say, estimating sales figures for the next quarter, or predicting how much budget you'll need for a certain initiative. Prescriptive analytics considers everything you've learned so far to inform your next steps. It usually involves machine learning, AI, and advanced algorithms. Prescriptive analytics is the most complex type of data analysis, and it's absolutely critical for tapping into opportunities, mitigating potential risks, and addressing issues. Together, these 4 types of data analytics help companies understand what's going on in their business, enabling them to figure out the best steps and strategies for the future. And there's one key person behind all this data wrangling and insight gleaning: a data analyst. So, what exactly is a data analyst, and what do they do? Data analysts are the experts who make data meaningful. They guide the company to make smart decisions that align with strategic goals, and they have a major impact on the company's success. They work closely with key stakeholders from different departments to define what questions and challenges need to be explored. Then they conduct the necessary analyses, share their findings, and provide insight-driven recommendations. This is all part of the data analysis process, which we'll cover in more detail in the next section of this video. Data analysts may also be responsible for setting up data-related systems and processes. For example, they may build and maintain interactive dashboards for real-time data tracking. As you can tell, data analytics is very hands-on, and it's extremely collaborative. Note that it's not purely technical either. It's also about problem-solving, storytelling, and driving impactful action. So, how do data analysts work their magic? Let's explore the data analysis process. The data analytics process involves 6 key steps. Step 1, define the question or problem you want to explore. Let's say you're a data analyst investigating the issue of student retention at an online education company. You might ask, why are students dropping out of their courses in the first few weeks? Step 2, collect relevant data that can help to answer your question. This might come from internal sources, like company records, or external sources like surveys or social media. Step 3, clean the data. Raw data is often messy and incomplete, so you'll need to clean it by removing duplicates, correcting errors, and formatting the data so it's easier to work with. Step 4 is where you're gonna analyze the data. With your data set freshly cleaned, it's time to dive in and figure out what the data is telling you. At this stage, you might calculate averages, identify trends, or run statistical analysis to find patterns. Step 5, visualize the data. Present your findings using clear visuals, like charts and graphs. This provides a snapshot of key insights, making it easy for decision makers to quickly grasp what the data actually means. Step number 6, share recommendations. Based on your analysis, you can suggest actionable steps that address the original question. With our student retention example, you might suggest improving student onboarding to reduce dropout rates. That's the data analytics process in a nutshell. Next, we'll consider what skills you need to work in the field. Data analysts are in high demand, and they're absolutely critical in every single industry. It's also an incredibly exciting career choice. How many jobs can you think of where you have such an opportunity to make a big impact? So, what does it take to become a data analyst? Like most jobs nowadays, you need a solid mix of hard and soft skills. Let's start with the hard skills, the technical expertise you'll need to actually carry out the data analysis process. This includes mastering specific tools such as SQL, Excel, and programming languages like Python and R. These are crucial for collecting, cleaning, and analyzing data efficiently. You'll also need to understand data visualization tools like Tableau and Power BI. This is how you turn raw numbers into clear, compelling insights. Of course, data analysts are proficient in mathematical concepts like statistics and probability. This includes things like calculating averages and correlations, measuring the likelihood of different outcomes, and applying statistical models to uncover trends. And what about soft skills? To really excel as a data analyst, you need to be a strong problem solver and think critically about what the data is telling you. You also need exceptional communication skills so that you can explain your insights to stakeholders, including people who aren't really data experts. And since data analytics is all about making better decisions, a good head for business, that goes a long way. You'll need to be able to understand the bigger picture and see where your insights can really make an impact. It's a mix of logic, creativity, and strategy. And that's what makes it such a fascinating job. You've probably already got some of the soft skills we've mentioned. And when it comes to learning the hard skills, don't worry about it. You don't need to go get some super technical degree. Really, any good quality online course will teach you everything you need to know, usually with hands-on projects that'll prepare you for the field. We know that data analytics is pretty hot right now, but what about the future? Over the coming years, the data analytics market is expected to see a compound annual growth rate between 25 and 30%. That's crazy. That's actually faster than other high-growth fields like software development and even AI. We're constantly generating incredible amounts of data, and we need skilled analysts who can turn it into something meaningful and actionable. If you're looking for a career where you can investigate high-stakes questions and challenges, problem-solve, and make a real impact, you might want to consider becoming a data analyst. We hope you've enjoyed learning what data analytics is all about, and that you can now start to envision what it might be like to work in the field. If you'd like to learn more about what it takes to become a data analyst, check out further videos in our series, such as our data analytics roadmap. In this video, we show you how to go from complete beginner to landing your first job. And be sure to check out Masterschool's data analytics program. If you're based in Germany, you can apply for a voucher to have your program fully funded by the German government. You'll find all the links you need in the description for this video. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more content, just like this. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again soon.